of Australia's leading female performers says she will continue to champion the push to change Australia's national anthem. In the 1960s, Judith Durham travelled Australia and the world with the Seekers and admits that at the height of her singing career, she didn't know anything about Australia's First Nations people.
It was 1966 and Hobart girl Judith Durham had found fame and fortune. The Seekers certainly were living in a world of their own.
Now bear in mind, I'm a middle-class white Australian. I have some Greek heritage, a great-grandfather who was a Greek immigrant, otherwise very much an English background. I had a very, very narrow view of the world. I was born in Melbourne, went to Tasmania for 5 years, and at that time we were taught about the fact that the last Aboriginal person had died, and the last Tasmanian person had died. Inside you,
hits like Georgie Girl that made The Seekers the first Australian artists to sell a million copies in the US.
The Seekers, we didn't even know we had any Aboriginal fans, if you can believe it. You know, truly, when we were given the Australian of the Year award, when you think about it, that was 1968. And in 1967, of course, you know, Aboriginal people got the vote, but we didn't have a clue all that was going on.
It wasn't until the 1980s, when living in Queensland, that Judith Durham's worldview on First Nations peoples began to crystallise through the writings of an American Indian, Chief Seattle.
We must teach our children that the earth is rich with lives, so they'll all respect their homeland.
Influenced by Aboriginal Australians like the late poet Udjuru Noonuccal and also Bob Weatherall and Gary Foley, Durham was moved into action in 2009, rewriting the lyrics of the Australian National Anthem.
So gradually my awareness was raised, and I was starting to understand that this was a very, very big subject. You can't just take on the lyric of a national anthem without a lot of profound thought and insight and people helping you and a lot of consultation.
Australia celebrates one.
The collaboration was between Durham and Yorta Yorta man Kutcher Edwards.
Australia, let us stand as one.
The song was then performed with Yorta Yorta soprano Deborah Cheetham. Judith Durham says the recent refusal by Deborah Cheetham to sing the anthem at the AFL Grand Final was a courageous step.
If someone like Deborah, who has the Order of Australia, I mean, she has been honoured by this country, but she's embarrassed and not free to sing words which are meaningless for someone who is an original Australian of heritage of our first Australians, how can she sing for we are young and free? Just that one line. She can't sing those words with sincerity. So I'm with her on that level alone.
But it may be sometime yet before that one line or even a new anthem is universally accepted, or in the words of a Seekers song, someday, one day.